నిరంతర న్యూస్ అప్డేట్స్ కోసం ఛానల్ ని సబ్స్క్రైబ్ చేయండి, పక్కనే ఉండే బెల్ సింబల్ ప్రెస్ చేయడం మర్చిపోకండి.
యాక్చువల్లీ ఐ హావ్ టు గో టు వరంగల్, దట్స్ వై ఐఎమ్ లీవింగ్ లిటిల్ ఎర్లీ. యూ షుడ్ ఆల్ ఎక్స్క్యూజ్ మీ. అవర్ ఫైనాన్స్ మినిస్టర్ విల్ జాయిన్ అండ్ హీ విల్ బి దేర్ టిల్ ద ఎండ్ ఆఫ్ ద మీటింగ్. ఇన్ అనదర్ 10-15 మినిట్స్ హీ విల్ బి జాయినింగ్ అస్. సో ఐఎమ్ ట్రావెలింగ్ అలాంగ్ విత్ మై డెప్యూటీ సీఎం టు స్విచ్ ఆన్ ద దేవాదల లిఫ్ట్ ఇరిగేషన్ స్కీమ్. టుడే వీ హ్యావ్ ఎ ప్రోగ్రామ్ ఇన్ వరంగల్ డిస్ట్రిక్ట్. ఐ హావ్ టు గో దేర్. But even though I have all respect for NABARD, I thought at least I will meet and I'll greet you in this occasion. So I came to this meeting. I have a very good association with NABARD. Being an irrigation and marketing minister, for the last 3.5 years I am working very closely with NABARD. We have shown some wonders in Mission Kakatiya and building up of these rural godowns. NABARD has funded almost more than 1,000 crores for the state of Telangana. After independence in the last 60 years, in the state of Telangana, the rural godowns which were available was only 4 lakh metric tons. But with the support of NABARD, in the last 1.5 year, we have built 18 lakh metric tons godown. That helped us, particularly with the construction of these godowns, it helped in two ways. One is, in the last years, I think you might have observed, when we were MLAs, when the state was not formed, every kharif we used to face this fertilizer crisis and seed crisis. Farmers used to stand up in the lines for hours together to buy their urea, DAP or seeds. So now, after constructing this rural godowns, our Honorable CM Chandrashekar Rao Garu, with a vision, he planned every mandal should have a godown not less than 5,000 metric tons. With this, it helped us in two ways. One is, we are bringing and keeping the stocks well before the kharif season begins, so that there is no problem of this pesticide or fertilizer or the seeds, number one. Number two, during the time of procurement. Procurement time also, sometimes because of the lack of godown's capacity, procurement used to be stopped. At the time, the traders used to decrease the rate and farmers used to lose many things. Now, after this rural godowns is constructed, we are able to buy all the produce of the farmers with at MSP rate. So that has also helped our state. So we thank NABARD for supporting the for the construction of godowns. And also about the Mission Kakatiya, which gained the popularity all over the country. Many states visited the state of Telangana and they went to the field and they understand the importance of this Mission Kakatiya. The Mission Kakatiya is, with less expenditure, without any court cases, without any further land acquisition, the old minor irrigation system got revived. With the Mission Kakatiya program, the state could achieve 5 lakh acres of new I-cut, which is stabilized. Before Mission Kakatiya, in any year, we have not touched 11 lakh acres of irrigation under this tank irrigation. But after Mission Kakatiya's 2 years experience, we in the last year, we achieved 16 lakh of acres I-cut under tank irrigation in Telangana. So 5 lakhs increased straight away, we could see. Number two, the productivity got increased. By the application of the silt which is removed from the tank, the farmers all applied the silt to their fields. With that, the usage of chemical fertilizer has gone down and the productivity got increased. That benefit also we have seen. Even that study report is also made by our Singh, NAPCON's. We have given the third party assessment to NAPCON's, our NABARD subsidiary agency. They only did the third party impact assessment and recently they have submitted the report. Even that report was appreciated by Ministry of Water Resource and our Honorable Union Minister Gadkari Garu. I have submitted the report to that. The state has done this program and NABARD has done the third party assessment. We got appreciation all over the state. For that also we thank NABARD. I have little less time, that's why I am cut-shorting my these things. And also, particularly in my constituency, our AGM NABARD, he helped me in driving a program called Milk Grid for Medak district. A separate program we have launched in Medak district that helped the rural farmers lot of additional income. Almost thousands of units we have grounded in Medak district. So even some of the units are even ready to launch, but we are trying to get some more subsidy clearance from union government. If once we get that also, we will try to launch further. That milk grid also, particularly in Honorable CM's constituency, Gajwel, where farmer suicides are more in Dubbak constituency, in my constituency, in Siddipet, in these 3-4 assembly segments, we have done this milk grid program with the help of Nabard. So finally, our RBI friend is also here, Mr. Subramanian ji. I have 2-3 issues I would, by using this occasion, I have to put forward. One is, all the banks are taking the passbooks of farmers. For as per the I know, as per the RBI guidelines, banks should not take the passbooks of the farmers for issuing the crop loans. I think no farmer in the state of Telangana have their passbooks with them. The reason you say is for verification purpose you are taking. Now the government of Telangana, our Honorable CM, is completely, after 80 years, all the revenue records got rectified. 96% of the records have got rectified. That even if it will help the bankers also. Many banks are facing a problem of this tampered passbooks, duplicate passbooks, where even banks are also facing problem. Now, all this data will be available in online. So, data is available. Pakka records are now transparent. Then why should the bank should take the passbooks? I request our lead bank, Mr. Manikandan Saab, and our RBI chief, RBI representative. So, please instruct your bankers not to take the passbooks. Not to take. All the passbooks are with you. Please return it to the farmers. Please return it to the farmers while issuing the renewal, you're renewing the pass. Because all the lead bank managers are here. After, if I leave also, I request RBI representative and our lead bank chief to give clear instructions, categorical instructions to give back the passbook to the farmers. The data is available now. No question of pahani, bringing pahani and all. Always you will ask for fresh pahani. The farmer has to roam around the tahsildar office. He has to get pahani. Then only you issue a crop loan. So this is my first request. Give back the passbook to the farmers, number one. Number two, the scale of finance and timely issuing the crop loan. Normally what happens, some of the branches also overloaded. In some of the districts what I see, there are many nationalized banks are opened, but the reorganization is not happened. Of course, districts are also now, new districts formed, and reorganization of the workload is very much required in the field. See, in my district, Siddipet, when I was attending the district level bankers meeting, there are almost 12 branches without any workload. Simply, they are doing commercial business. They are not doing women lending, or they are not doing these crop loans or farmers lending. When I asked them, they said, "Arey, sir, you have to reorganize the workload." There is another bank called SBI. They have almost 48 villages. When I asked that manager, "Arey, bhai, it is getting delayed." He said, "What can I do, sir? I have 48 villages. Every day I can do one or two villages. It will take me 90 days. 90 days, your cropping period. Your crop itself ends. When you are giving the crop loan, when the crop is coming to cutting, you are issuing the crop loan. Almost you are entering into Rabi." So there are two issues. One is to reorganize the banks, to redistribute the workload, number one. Number two, and see that the crop loans are given in time. For example, our chief minister, for the first time in the country, he announced a program to issue 4,000 rupees per acre as a crop investment. Particularly farmers in the beginning season, they require for purchase of seed, for cultivation purpose, they require for many other purposes. So what we are planning, our chief minister has planned to give it them in the month of May itself. Because June his work starts. In the month of May only, we want to give it to the farmers. Why not our bank should plan? Our Kharif loan scheme starts in the month of June, July. Our DL district level bankers meeting itself we will do in the month of June, July about the crop loans. By that time his real investment will over. Otherwise, he is going to the money lenders and is bringing at the higher rate of interest. By the time we give, it is not useful to the farmers. So, my submission is you plan. to issue the crop loans from the month of May only, finish it by the end of the June, so that the real benefit will go to the farmers. This is my second request. Third request is scale of finance. See, many times what happening, this is I am repeating continuously in this, for the last 10 years I am saying, but no change. Every meeting, every occasion I try to raise this issue, but it doesn't resolve so far. My problem is, see, for cotton your scale of finance is more. Maize and paddy it is little less. So farmer in the physically in the field is going for maize cultivation nor paddy cultivation, but he is taking the loan on cotton because the scale of finance is more. He doesn't know, the poor farmer, you are cutting 6% for insurance. The poor farmer is losing 6% as he is taking loan on the cotton. His crop loan is cut by 6%. If at all because of dry weather or some problem, if he doesn't get the crop also, he don't get the insurance because he has done maize cultivation. Again, some of the farmers, they are paying for maize as an individual loanee, as an individual farmer, he is paying crop insurance to the insurance company on maize. So the farmer on one field, one farmer, in the bank he is paying for cotton and in the field he is paying for maize. So two crop insurances he is doing. If at all he doesn't do also, he will not get the insurance. So kindly increase the scale of finance so that the farmer should take the loan which he grows. But you are, because of your workload, I can understand the field officer cannot visit the field of every farmer. It is difficult to even to the banker also. You have your own problems. But the government of Telangana recently, we have appointed many agriculture extension officers. For every 5,000 acres, we have an agriculture extension officer. So that agriculture extension officer will recognize every farmer. He will identify, he will have all the data including cell phone numbers and what the crop he is growing. If you can sail with them, if you can work together with our agriculture department, the banker's job will become very easy. And proper guidance will be given to the farmer. Agriculture department and the banker should work together while lending the crop loans. This is one more my request. So increase the scale of finance, work along with our agriculture extension officers in the field. Number four, I would like to request Nabard. I already requested personally our Manikandanji, sorry, our Radhakrishnanji, our please give us some support in building up these cold storages. Already you helped us in godowns. Now the state of Telangana, we want to build some cold storages in bigger markets like Warangal, Hyderabad, Gaddi Annaram fruit market, our Boinpalli vegetable market. So it will help our local farmers. I request you to please support in constructing these cold storages. And also, as you mentioned, this year your focus is on per crop, per drop, more crop. The state of Telangana is also moving in the same line. Recently, in Nizamabad district, we have gone for this drip irrigation system, piped irrigation system, which is successfully done by the state of Madhya Pradesh. Now, 2.5 lakh acres program under Kaleshwaram project, on a trial basis, we are doing in the district, Nizamabad district, where through SRSP project under Kaleshwaram program, we are going to build this piped irrigation for 2.5 lakh acres. So you are financing the states through Government of India, but within the FRBM. So I was always requesting at Government of India level and you also, please consider states like Telangana, which has highest growth rate in the country, please give us out of FRBM, at least for irrigation, where irrigation is very, very important. The state of Telangana is focusing more on particularly on agriculture sector. Agriculture means it is directly not lending only to the farmer. Where Mission Kakatiya is part of agriculture, our major irrigation, our plan is to achieve 1 crore acres of irrigation in the state of Telangana through major and medium irrigation projects. So that is also part of agriculture only. Building godowns, building these cold storages, supporting 4,000 rupees per acre, giving more drip and sprinkler irrigation. Of course, you have helped us in 1,000 crores for drip irrigation also. NABARD has supported the state of Telangana by giving 1,000 crores for drip irrigation. So all these things are indirectly or indirectly which were support, this is support to the agriculture and agriculture allied activity. So almost in our budget also more than 50% we are spending on agriculture and agriculture allied activity. For example, for irrigation, our state has, in our budget, we have allocated 25,000 crores for irrigation. So our priority is agriculture. Our priority is farmer. So NABARD is also, particularly your priority is also NABARD, farmer and agriculture sector. We will work together in the best interest of the farmer and supporting this agriculture sector. So once again, I would like to congratulate the NABARD and your team. Please focus the issues which I have raised, and I would like to extend my heartfelt thanks on behalf of the government of Telangana for supporting this state, and we expect to support further. Thank you.
State focus paper for 2018-19.